We are mujeres libres. We are Kurdish guerrilla fighters. We are gulabi gang Indian woman warriors. We are the woman partisans fighting fascism. We are the struggling mothers. We are the nature who loves us. We are all the revolutionary women of then and now. We are the wise women burnt as witches rising from the ashes. Today we celebrate our identity as the heritage of struggle worldwide. We are internationalist women in North and Eastern Syria, inside the Rojava revolution. Today we celebrate Newroz, which is an expression of the fight for the Kurdish identity, which is a fight for freedom and existence. It's the beginning of spring. Our eyes and ears are opening, and we can see that our road to freedom is now taking a new turn. Looking at the history of the world, all living beings have faced periods of extreme conditions. Many times, we have survived and evolved. We are part of a cycle of millions of years. Crisis moments like the one we face today due to coronavirus have given us the opportunity to see and build. Women here have built revolution and self-organization from the ashes of war. War is always around us, but has many different masks. In exceptional situations, the deep cracks and lack of human ethics reveal the foundations of the patriarchal, profit-driven system. As state institutions and organizations fail to provide and take advantage by exerting control and oppression, we strengthen our existing communities and the ties between the peoples all over the planet. We act as we have always done, as the strong society we are, thinking of those in the refugee camps, in the prisons, those women who face domestic violence, those who without work cannot buy food, those who have nobody to care for. These moments of chaos can open up new possibilities of life in our minds. Even if the circumstances demand us to keep a distance, we find ways of sticking together. Our Zapatista revolutionary comrades in Mexico also tell us, we call to not lose human contact, but to temporarily change the ways of knowing us comrades, brothers and sisters. Words and the power of listening, along with the heart, have many different ways, many calendars and many geographies to come together. And this fight for humanity is one of them. As the capitalist system falls apart, the only thing that can ensure us is us. Whilst the whole world talks about how to fight the virus, we talk about why and for what we are fighting. Freedom has to grow from within each one of us and be spread in our togetherness, despite restrictions. The corona crisis cannot be an open door for fascism, for the reinforcing of oppression, inequality and isolation. States all over the world are also taking advantage of this moment, using the fear of the people to gain more power. We will only survive if we stay collective, in whichever ways we can. The problem is the solution. Every struggle brings a fight and wisdom. Our self-defense system is inside nature. Life cannot be prescribed in a form of lifestyle or chemical medicines, which are fighting against my linear of knowledge, which lay in the hands and hearts of the women. Health is caring for the community. It is love for our existence and the land we walk, the life around us. Health is the ethics that brings society together. It is the balance of our biodiversity. The health of our society is now facing a new threat, which is also part of the ways of living that separates us from each other and nature. We are together in this, in solidarity with those who lost their lives and all the people who are fighting, every day, everywhere. Revolutionary hugs with deepest love and respect.